Hi guys, welcome back to Go for Crafts. Subscribe the channel if you have not subscribed, because we are making it as a training session, starting from the wrapping, then joining, decoration. So it will go in a systematic way, and press the bell button to get all the notifications time to time. Okay, today in our video we will be watching how to wrap the Chandbali shapes. Like, these are the Chandbali shapes which are available in market. So these threading we will be watching in our channel today. So there is a very small techniques, and when you start wrapping here, it is very easy from this part to this part. From here to here there is a little difficulty you may face initial stages. That how to come over those difficulty phases, I will let you know today. Let us see what are all the materials required. So we require the chandbalis. So again, you will get different sizes, these chandbalis, like a smaller size, and this is the medium size. More than this, two more big sizes will come. And we require the fabric glue. And once again, I'm suggesting use the fabric glue only for thread works. And we want a basic material like scissor and a rough cloth to wipe your fingers whenever you touch the glue, and the thread. Like, I have taken a blue color thread here, the silk thread. So I have took around eight round counts, means it will come around 16 counts. Let us see the procedure now. So I have taken a thread count of 16, and I am applying the glue widely. Hold the thread widely and apply the glue. And as I told you again, I am not gonna use the needle. So I am making the end part little sharp and giving it a needle finishing touch. Hope you have tried the jhumkas and tic tacs, beads. So this is the fourth video, the fourth shape. So apply little glue. When it comes to chandbali, see, you can start the threading from here also, but for more conveniency and more easiness to avoid the slipping area more, I suggest you to start from here. This part, when you start, initially you can able to cover this part easily without slipping, because these are all again straightly you can put it. This little part, this middle part, you have to apply the same technique like a triangular threading basis. So the same technique, like hold the thread widely. And make sure there won't be any over threadings in a thread. Like, if you have over threading, it will be visible in the finishing, it will be visible like a awkward. Whichever side you stick a glue, that side will be the back side of the bali. Like, whenever you are taking it to the designing, like when you are using it as a pendant or else you are using it as a earring, that should go into the back side. And front, you make sure you will not touch the glue more, because it will cause the change of the color. So this is how you will stick the thread here. Then you will start wrapping. So like how? Should take this. And here, don't try to round the thread, you try to round the bali, so that it will be easily you can fix it. See, the second threading. So once you turn this, and the next one, try to hold it widely. And here, probably some two triangles you should take, like one here and the next threading should be, otherwise what happens if you keep on going like this, the threads will be slanting, so that will affect the look of the chandbali. So here, say you should make sure all this thread should look straight, so like this. And then I am making here a triangle. See, now this thread is straight towards the center round. Now you should fill the gap. Now goes to the next filling. Two, three techniques, like hold the thread tightly, drag the thread, like this side by side you have to do. Bali shape, like from the middle part it will be very width broad, and here it will goes on decreasing, so the thread level seems to be up and down. So every time whenever you are going to thread it, you have to properly pull it tightly and make sure it will be broad enough, the thread also it will cover the Bali correctly, otherwise there are chances like it will look like over threading or loose threading. So those who are learning at initial stages, they if they want, they can even put the glue at the borders like this. You can put the glue at the border so that the thread won't move, and you will like it will be convenient to you to thread. But once you got experience, you need not to put the glue like this. But make sure the glue will not come the front part of the Bali. So when you come to an end, the thread like it will have more twist and extras and all, so it will automatically will go like a it will miss out the broadener shape, so you keep on drag it broadly, otherwise the shape of the Bali will be like up and downs, it will be thicker in some areas and lean in some areas, so you have to keep on drag it and make sure it will be like width enough. So basically you have to turn the Bali so you will get a proper shape. So when you try to turn the thread only like this, so people usually will do like this also. But if you start doing this, there are chances like thread will become loose. This is how Bali made. As I told you, once you, wherever you start, you try to end up at that point and make sure this will become the back side of your whatever design you are taking it forward for. Like apply the glue widely and try to fix the thread also broadly so that the glue will be touching to every thread, each and every thread, and there are no chances of thread detachments. So this is how bali should be made. So if you see, you will not make out which is starting point and which is the ending point. So this is how a chandbali should be wrapped. Now next video we will be watching the other shape in bali, is like tilak shape. And for the conveniency of the viewers, we are also have this video in other languages also. Please subscribe the channel. Thank you.